My main aim is, one, to introduce you to the common skin conditions, how to diagnose them, what are the difficulties in diagnosis, what could be the differential diagnosis, and why do we manage in a particular, this is a very important thing. My majority problem comes from many of, I'm not saying homeopathists, but many even general practitioners. When we start a dose of steroid, immediately says, oh, no need of giving steroids. We can take management. But, you know, there is always a rationale in giving any management. And let me just do one thing to show you some common skin conditions. Actually, the names are written down. I should have not done that. But let's see if I can do that. This is a very common. See, infections are very common. And this is, can you see them properly? I think I should sit down here. The things are looking much better here. Can you shut off the lights? Yeah. Yeah, things are a little better now. Okay. Now, before I come to fungal infections, I think let me show you first common conditions. I'm waiting for a very beautiful CD which has all the lectures of for undergraduates, which will be useful to you as well. And I will also give you how to examine. So let's start with just as a warm-up because I also need to sort of understand you all. So remember that the regional morphology of lesions are very important. You know, how do I diagnose dysesthesia, fungal infection? Tell me, why do you diagnose? What must be your criteria to diagnose that this is ringworm infections? What is the meaning of ringworm? So it's like a ring. What is the meaning of that? That means there is a central healing and an advancing edge, right? Now, fortunately, that is the way. Unfortunately, there is always a modified tinea. Modified because the patient has used support lotion, support malam, irritants. Or the most master of everything is Betnavet GM. Because most people give just a dark shot that something will work within that. So what will happen? When I talk to you, I'll tell you that the advancing edge is because of a hypersensitivity reaction of the body to the organism. Now let me tell you, let me give you my way of telling you, because the science is different, but you must understand that we have two type of cells immunologically in the white cells. You know, the T cells and the B cells. The T cells are mediating mainly protection towards T cell mediatory is mainly, if you see, because you'll find the deficiency of T cells coming with major diseases in HIV/AIDS. So these are tuberculosis, right? Fungal infection, bacterial infection, viral infections, and many other infections. T cell has a helper cell called CD4 cell. The CD4 is a helper cell, and that is the reason for all HIV/AIDS cases. We want to know what is the level of CD4 count. Why are we looking at? We're looking at the helper T cell. Now, this helper T cell is suppressed by whether you give immunosuppressives, of which steroid is one of the main this thing, whether you give topical or oral. So what happens? Your body, and this is very funny, that your body knows what is mine and yours, not mine. So the moment a fungal infection comes in contact, and we shall talk about more things about how a human being, whether it is a soil, whether it is human to human contact, and the morphology changes. But just let me give you a backdrop of here, that when you have this hypersensitivity reaction, the patient start getting it. Now remember one thing, for example, scabies. I transmit scabies to you. For 1 month, there is no symptom. Why? Because the body doesn't know this is mine or not mine. It's taking time. The first time, it takes time because there is a T cell mediated. From the contact site where the organism is deposited, they are picked up by the cells, they are taken to the regional lymph node. The regional lymph node, there are cells which are created. Oh, this is not me. This is not mine. Let's have a very good response. Let's throw it out. So what do? There is an effector cell which come back, and the site where it occurs, there is a papule formation. So when you see scabies, Oh, web spaces. Are there anything on the web spaces? Why are we looking at that? Because these are the sites which tells you the presence of the organism. And how do we know the presence of organism? Because of the body's hypersensitivity reaction. Okay? So all that thing gets merged. It's the same thing true with a fungal infection. That you have a fungal infection and it's mounting a hypersensitivity reaction in immunosuppressed people, and that's the reason when you have an extensive tinea corporis, extensive, you wonder why, and this question should come in your mind. Is the patient anemic? Is the patient has any other immunosuppression? Is it a case of patient on steroids? Is the patient on any other cyclophosphamide or any other immunosuppressive? Is it a case of renal transplant? Is this a case of HIV? Or immunological. There are primary immunological congenital immunodeficiency syndromes. So whenever an individual comes with extensive, now remember, it is very funny, which I have tried to show, is on the lower part, the woman and this one is the husband. So there is a conjugal infection, right? And that is the reason, whenever you treat any infection in dermatology, the principle is that you treat the patient and you look for the disease in others, right? Unless you look now, sometimes they don't come, and I'll also give you the reason why it comes. And while I'm warming up, I'll tell you why. See, in human beings, if there is a organism, say Trichophyton rubrum, T. rubrum, you'll get that when I show you the slides. T. rubrum is anthropophilic. That means loved by the human beings, you know, it loves human being and so this parasitism, whatever relationship, is very friendly. So the T. rubrum is with you on your body for a long period of time without eliciting any problems. So when you are examining your patient and suddenly you will find tinea in the groin, and the patient has come for every other thing, but he doesn't tell you that he has a tinea because it's okay with him, it's not bothering him. So that is because there is a great degree of tolerance to the human species. But examine that you have a cat or a dog in the house and you get transmitted that infection. We call it zoophilic infection. That is not belonging to your species. So your body mounts a very vehement reaction. For example, we have something called tinea capitis. When I show you the slides of tinea capitis, I'll show you what is called chirion formation. And looking at the chirion response, the first question we ask is, do you have a pet in the house? Are you in contact with any of the pets? Because it is zoophilic. So you know, the class of, when you may think this is just tinea, what is there to look? But in the mind of a dermatologist, there are a lot of issues go by. One is at the site, that this is a common site. One thing, can you see both, all of them are obese? So obesity is a predisposing factor, friction is a predisposing factor, moisture retention, women work in the field, women work in the house, the petticoats and the saris get wet. So these are the wet areas. Sweating in our country is so common. So again a wet area. So groin, waist, in between the toes, these are some of the spaces where tinea infection lurks. So when I talk about tinea infection, I'll talk to you a little later. This is a term, onychomycosis. What is the meaning? Onycho is nail, mycosis is fungal infection. Now remember one thing, there are 110 causes of onychomycosis. Okay? And the biggest mistake everybody used to do is to treat it with griseofulvin. And I'll talk to you about what is dermatophytic infection and non-dermatophytic infection. Have you heard of the name Candida albicans? Yeah? Candida albicans is a yeast or a mold, while dermatophytes, that is the one which causes ringworm, is a dermatophytic infection.